I learned about it Friday night, and even though they hadn't released the names yet, we were able to figure out that it was our family. So it was devastating news that traveled pretty fast. The children were sweet, kind, loving, beautiful little boys. Just gentle hearts, rule followers, good kids.
What do you do as a school when something like this happens? How do you react to something like this when you have hundreds of kids and staff that were close to these boys?
Well, you offer as many services as you can for students and for staff. The district has been phenomenal about bringing in a crisis team to our school. Our staff has been phenomenal about organizing around what needs to be done, conversations that need to happen, and support that needs to be given. Some people react immediately. Some of us humans react, it takes a little bit lengthier time, so we know that support's not only going to be today, it's going to be throughout the whole school year from our staff.
What grades were they in?
Avery was in fifth grade, and Aridin was in third grade.
And had they been at your school?
The whole time, yes. Yes.
Just walk us through, I mean, I know it's hard to put it into words, but kind of the atmosphere this morning, I know it's very sad, obviously, but is everybody pulling together too?
Sure, everybody's pulling together at Gilmore Lane. We are a small school, one of the smallest schools in the district, with only approximately 270 students. So we have a very much a family atmosphere in the school. Everybody is pulling together. Everybody has a role today. Everybody's pulling through and meeting the needs of our kiddos.
And there's no way, obviously, to prepare yourself for this, but what's going to get you guys through in the next coming days, weeks, months? As you said, it's a process, right?
Sure, it's a process. What's going to get us through is just leaning on each other and talking about it and finding out even more ways how to support our kids.
Thank you.
Thank you. Fire away.
Dr. Polio, why did you feel it was important for you yourself to be here this morning at Gilmore Lane?
As we put together a plan over the weekend to support the school and the community here in JCPS, the school community, first and foremost, it was to get a team in place here of caring, compassionate individuals, professionals that are able to come and give support to students and staff, the principal, parents, anybody who might need that, because this is such a devastating situation. But also just to provide my support to Sam and his staff. I don't know if there's a whole lot I can do, but I think just being here is important for me to show that I'm here to support this, because you know, we do have 155 schools, but we are a JCPS family and we all work for the same cause. And so anytime there is tragedy, we want to be here to support each other.
When did you hear that this involved two of your students?
Late Friday evening, I just finished the football game. Football game that I attended at Ballard High School. It was on my way home when I found out that there was this potentially could be a situation with two of our students. Didn't get a lot of details until midday Saturday, but did find out Friday evening.
Is this something that the school district, you know, has like a plan in a drawer or prepared for? I mean, obviously you hate to put something like this into motion, but do you guys have a plan? I know it's happened before.
Yeah, so. Well, you know, we have a crisis team that is ready. We have counselors that actually sign up from other schools who come in and support our staff and students in need. And Alicia Averett, assistant superintendent, and her team do a fantastic job of putting together a plan. Obviously, it's hard to put together a playbook on how you're going to deal with each individual situation, because they are so different. And at no time could anyone anticipate something like this happening. But we do have to be ready, and we do have to have structures in place. By midday Saturday, our people and our at central office and throughout this district were moving and putting a plan in action to support the students and the families here at Gilmore Lane. So, you know, obviously the, you know, we grieve just like anybody else with the students, but our number one role in the situation as it occurred is to make sure that we support the families and the school here as they are coming to school on Monday, so that we can help them with the grieving process.
Can you talk about that crisis management team? Who's involved, how you become part of that group, and just specific roles in that group?
Sure. Well, it's mostly our school counselors. So we have our professional staff, Alicia Averett and her team. She's the assistant superintendent over and works with many of our counselors. And so they put together a team, and counselors from schools all over the district volunteer to be a part of that team, that when there is a crisis that occurs, that they go into action. So we have 101,000 students in 155 schools, and so unfortunately things are going to happen that are going to require a crisis team throughout the school year. You know, we never want it to be as devastating as this, but we have to be prepared for that. And so it is really school counselors is the main part of the team, but also professionals that we have in central office that are able to put together information for parents and families that come in. Every kid in the school is going to have information sent home with them today for their families to access. Parents can tap into resources on how to discuss things with their children about the situation, support they might need. We want to be able to have this team to give families support, not just today, but ongoing. So as Sam said, many of the families might not and people grieve in different ways, so the families might not see or need help until later in the week. So we want to have this team that's available to the school throughout the week and the year as problems occur. So we just want to be here to support the school and the families.
Is there something that you can do beyond the school hours for these families? Is that part of the support system? You know, these kids might come home today and be really sad or talk to their parents. Maybe some parents don't know yet. Yeah. What happened? What can you do for that?
Yeah, it's a good question. I mean, I'm confident that Sam and his staff will be available well past school hours. I know for a fact, talking yesterday, that Sam was here at the school yesterday and gave a good amount of his weekend preparing for today. And so I know that he will be available and his staff will be available well after school hours. And as I've told him, all of us at central office will be available at any time to make sure that we help with any families who might need help. So I know the school will be very active in making sure that the families have a way to communicate to the school if needed to be after hours.
How long will the district provide this support?
As long as is needed. You know, and there is no time frame that we will say how long that will be, because each situation is different. So could very easily, we could see in a couple days where they might need us day-to-day support, but if the school feels that after a week that more support is needed, we'll initiate the team back and be right back here. So we'll be here as long as is needed for the school community.
And I know you said you're sending, obviously, that paperwork home for parents for ideas, mm-hmm. for support. If you could offer maybe them one bit of advice, you know, in talking to their kids,
Well, I mean, I think the most important thing that I would recommend to parents at any time, whether it just be every single day after school or in a crisis situation, is to talk to their children, to ask questions, to talk about how they're feeling, you know, whether they understand what's happening, you know, and try to use the references that we give to see if there's any signs of distress from the students. But I would recommend that to parents every single day, that talking with their child and asking questions and finding out what's going on at school and how they're doing is so critical. And in today's world, sometimes, you know, it's very difficult to sit down and just talk and have conversations. But that my recommendation more than anything would be to talk to them, have a conversation, understand how they're feeling. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.